I want you to see the first key to receiving deliverance from demons, and that is this: submit to Jesus as your Lord. I want you to notice what I did not say. I did not say to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior, because many of us do that. Freedom does not come when you receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Salvation does. Freedom comes when you submit, not receive. You submit yourself to the Lordship of Jesus Christ. The Bible makes me to understand where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. The correct translation says this: where the Spirit is Lord, there is freedom. Devil does not respond to Jesus as an insurance card. Devil responds to authority. Demons respond to authority. And when you walk under authority of the Lordship of Jesus Christ, Satan reacts toward that. The problem with many of us is this: is we receive Jesus as a spare tire and we pull him out when things get hard. We receive Jesus as an insurance card and we pull him out when the police pulls us over. Jesus Christ is not just my Savior, he is my Lord. And some people are afraid to make Jesus their Lord. They say, he'll take all my fun away. He'll cause me to shut down this and shut down that. Listen, I would rather be Jesus' servant than devil's slave. Did you know that Satan entered Judas during communion? How could he do that if Judas associated with Jesus? How could he do that if Judas was with Jesus? If you ever read the Bible carefully, you will see this. Judas always referred to Jesus as a teacher, never as a master. Other disciples called him master. Judas never called him master. He always called him teacher, rabbi. If you want to be protected and you want to be free from the devil's grip, Jesus cannot just be your rabbi. He can't just be a motivational speaker or a figure from history. He has to be your Lord. And then he says he came to heal the brokenhearted. See, before he gets to the demon part, he says about you need to establish the Lordship. Who is the Lord in your life? Number one. Number two is there needs to be the inner healing that happens. And inner healing happens only through one way, is forgiveness. Forgive if you want to be free. Before you can be free, you have to forgive. Whatever hurts and pains people caused you, these pains can actually attract demons. Why? Because when wounds are neglected, they become infected. When you neglect the wounds and you say that time will heal it all, see, time doesn't heal. Time helps to heal. Bible didn't send the clock to bring healing. Jesus came to bring healing. In book of Acts, there was a man named Simon and he was a sorcerer. He dabbled in witchcraft and he participated in all of that stuff. And he got saved superficially. He came and wanted to receive the power of God by paying money. And Apostle Peter looked at him and said this. He said, you are poisoned with iniquity. You are poisoned with bitterness and you are bound by iniquity, poisoned by bitterness and bound by iniquity. Actually, in Simon's life, probably there has been some kind of an event that caused bitterness to build up in his heart. And when he became poisoned with bitterness, that opened the door to be bound by iniquity. And you may say, I have the right to be bitter. Ha! Satan has the right to hold on to you too. Is freedom and deliverance comes by revelation, not just manifestation. I want you guys to see this. In Isaiah 61 verse 1, it says that Jesus came to proclaim liberty to the captives. It didn't say Jesus came to deliver the captives. The way he delivers the captives is by proclaiming liberty into their life. He proclaims that liberty. See, many times we reduce deliverance and freedom to manifestation instead of proclamation or instead of revelation. You are free not when you shake and bake. You are free when you receive prayer and you receive that knowing, I am free. What if you don't shake and bake? You are free. How do you receive your salvation? You receive your salvation when you pray the prayer, you place your trust in Jesus, and you receive that knowing that I am saved. If you don't cry, you're still saved. If you didn't fall, you're still saved. If you come from this sanctuary and you have doubts, you're still saved. Even if you fall into sin, you're still saved. Now you deal with your issues as a saved person, not as a lost person. When you receive that deliverance inside of you, it's important to understand that when you fall into sin after you're delivered, Satan's number one goal is going to be to convince you you're no longer delivered and to drag you through the mud of regret. And that regret will feel like repentance, but in reality, it only messes you up. Satan will always hang a person whom he can trap in regret. If he can trap you in regret, listen, he pushes you into sin. And the moment you fall into sin, he has another trap. And this trap is worse than your sin. It's called regret. If he has you in regret, listen, he has you on his fingertips. It's only a matter of time and he begins to hang you. The part of your life the devil doesn't have control over is more powerful than the part he does. But in here, he also, the Bible says, not only he proclaims liberty to the captives, he also opens the prison doors. That means there's two types of bondages. There's the one where you are a prisoner and there's one where you are a slave. If you're a slave, he sends a word. If you're a prisoner, he unlocks the key. He unlocks the prison. He comes and unlocks the prison, but I want you to see what he does not do. He does not drag you out of your prison. He opens the prison door. That means it's a generational curse. Well, the prison door means you have a demonic influence in your life. Jesus comes in and through the prayer line, Jesus comes in, maybe through somebody prays with you, maybe you meet with somebody, you go to a conference, whatever the scenario or the case, or maybe at home, and Jesus opens the door like an angel did to Peter when Peter was in prison. The angel came in and the Bible says the door was open, the guards were asleep, the chains fell off, and angel hits Peter and says this, "Arise, put on some clothes and follow me quickly." You have a very short moment of time to leave the prison. What is a prison? It's your mindset, it's your habits, and it's your friends. He opens the prison door, but he doesn't drag you out. He asks you, "Arise, put on some clothes and follow me quickly." That means if you got prayed for, you got about an hour or two before those guards that Jesus set you free from wake up. And this is what could happen. In a day, they can be hanged and you can be promoted. But if you chill here, if you hang out here, if you don't walk out from your prison, a wrong mindset, wrong habit, and a wrong set of friends, if you don't walk out from your prison, the guards will wake up and next day there will be reinforcements. How do I become free? I submit to the Lordship of Jesus. I receive healing and I receive revelation. Jesus sets me free. And lastly is, I walk out from the moment Jesus cracks the window open, the door open. I run from that like a crazy guy, following the Lord quickly, leaving my prison, my mindset, meaning this, I'm no longer bound. I am free, who's still fighting the devil. I'm no longer sick. I am healed, who's fighting sickness. I'm no longer weak. I am strong, who's fighting weakness. I'm no longer defeated. I am victorious, who's fighting defeat. My mindset changes. I'm not a victim. I'm a victor who's still fighting a victim tendencies.